If you're like me, you have more bicycles than you know what to do with. And with two kids, the bikes just started adding up, and pretty soon I had some trouble finding places to put them in the garage. So I decided a bike rack would be necessary to help organize all these. And 4 or 5 years ago, when I made this bike rack, it was really just a prototype, but it ended up being fine as it was, and I really haven't had to change anything. So today, what I want to do in this video is show you the construction of this bike rack and give you the measurements so you can make your own. The key to this whole thing is that I'm using easy to find wood. It's pressure treated, but it's off the shelf. And I made this one out of scraps, but you can buy this stuff for really just probably 20 or 30 bucks will buy you enough wood to buy this whole to make this whole rack. So I'm going to show the construction methods here, and then I'll give you the measurements. You can see the bikes of different styles fit in here fine. This right here is a mountain bike with 26-inch wheels. And here's a smaller kid's bike with smaller wheels. Over here is a road bike with 27-inch wheels. So all of them fit well, and there's enough space between the bikes so that you can get them in there, but you're not wasting any space either. And what I'm using for wood, and again, this was just scrap wood I had on hand, but this is a piece of decking. It's 5/4 by 6 decking, pressure treated, and this is cut in half, okay? And on the bottom here, I happen to use a piece of 2x that I had, but you could also use the decking down here. For the bottom frame, here it's 2x, and this was a 2x6 cut in half. And again, on the ends, this is radius decking, a 5/4 by 6 radius decking cut in half. And then for the uprights, these are just deck balusters. When you're making a railing, you would use these balusters, and they come, I believe these were cut to size already, so I didn't even have to do anything to those. So that's the basic instruction. Everything's put together with screws, which helps hold it together. And I'm going to give you the dimensions here, but I'll step back just to give you an idea of what this thing looks like. It's very, very simple, but it's held up over 4 or 5 years of use now. All right, so let me get close up here and I'll give you the exact dimensions you need to make this for yourself. All right, first I'm going to come down here in the bottom and give you the width of this thing. This part right here, going from here to here, is important because that's how the wheels fit in there. And you want the tires to be just off the ground so that the bike stands upright. So my dimensions here from that side is 12.5 inches, okay? And if you went the whole distance, the width here, you're at 26 inches. Now, this dimension over here is not as critical, but this one here where the tire sits in is pretty important. So that's 12.5 inches, and that allows any size tire to sit up off the ground so it won't, well, so it'll stay upright. All right? Now, the height is also pretty important. And for this height here, doing this one-handed, I've got, what is that, 30 3/4. And that's important because you want the tires to have enough space to clear. I could actually go a little bit lower here, but that seems to work out pretty good. So 30 3/4 for the total height. And these balusters, see if I can do this one-handed. I need an assistant. Yeah, these balusters are about the same height. Then the other very important dimension is between the balusters. You need enough space for all size tires to fit. What I have here is just about 3 inches, and then in between, so you have enough room. Let me just see what my centers are here. It's a 16-inch center. So in between each grouping there is 16 inches. So the total length, in this particular case, I have room for 5 different bikes, and it's 69 inches. But your dimensions can vary as far as the length, because as long as you have the distance between here and here set up correctly, it really doesn't matter. You can go as long as you like. And then this little thing right here, this little angle piece, again, is not that critical what the angle is. Just mark it and measure it. And as long as it's strongly attached, it really doesn't matter what that is. So those are the key dimensions. And you could make the dimensions a little bit different, I think, and still get away with it. But the important part is to get the 3 inches here, the 16 inches from here to here, and then the rest is not important except for this section right here. And as I said, on the bottom here, I used decking, but you could use 2x4 if you wanted, or 2x6 cut in half, either one, if you wanted to. And same thing with this. I happen to have these scraps around, but it's not really that important. You just need enough off the ground so that the tire is staying clear. So this is a 2x6 cut in half, so you're at 2 3/4 here. Or so, 2 5/8. And I would definitely recommend putting this together with screws, not nails, so that when it rocks back and forth, when you're putting the bikes in and out, it stays together. But this has been a good little rack for me, and I really don't think I'd change anything as far as the design. So I encourage you to make one, and it's really not that difficult.